she's her got this finish or about this big gable down, and I'm gonna go through every step of the way over a few videos all about the scud coat, the foundations of which we're gonna do everything else and holds the whole job together. The second video of this rendering series is gonna be all about the second coat, the scratch coat. Third video, top coat of sand cement render, will be all about applying the render, ruling it off and getting it straight, ready to be rubbed up and finished. Last but not least on this series is going to be about applying and finishing the acrylic render, just as shown here.
Next, scribe back plastering.
Right, so guys, next stage here, we'll have it all rendered. We need to get our acrylic primer on before we can do any acrylicing. So you want to have that on 24 hours before you do your acrylic. Just going to simply mix up the tub, give it a roller on and cut the angles and stuff in. Again, it was very, very wet the night before, so we'll probably give this a wee while, brighten up a wee bit more, and then crack on and bring the top down. The top's still a wee bit wet with the rain been hitting, so we'll let that dry and then we'll crack on from there. I'll give you a wee quick clip of it getting rollered on.
So I've cut some in here, give it all a mix up. Very important to mix this gear up just to make sure it's well mixed and there's nothing settling at the bottom. So sort of cut in the reveals here, and then what I do is just roller the flats. And again guys, if anything does splat on the windows or flick on the windows, make sure and wash that off straight away. Same as the roller, if you plan on using the roller again, leave it in a bucket of water or something. Otherwise it will be rock hard and you don't want that. But you can see this stuff does cover well. I think it does, one bucket does like 100 square meters.
That's it all primed, ready to go for acrylic. Technically cool with that tomorrow, but I doubt it's gonna probably be dry. So we want sort of 2 days dry in a row before we actually put the acrylic on. But that'll be okay to sit, even if it rains now, for a day or two. Hopefully we get a dry week. Hopefully, but yeah, quite a lot of work put into doing our acrylic render, guys.
If I had no bad luck, I have no luck at all. This actually, some of it washed off and had to be re-primed. Huh.
And a bit of a quick unboxing. Have the old Plazzy Flex for finishing it here, but got some new blades. And handles. So, all different types. I think the M2 is going to be probably the best. Maybe the two grey ones. Keep it the two grey ones here. And just slide the handles in. Click and clack, I think these are called, these ones. But yeah, glad these came in time, because Plazzy Flex was the only one I could find. So yeah, so I'll give you a wee bit of footage here of getting it finished up and maybe applied and stuff as well.
Right, so really getting down to it now, guys. So again, kind of job that's great if you have a mate to help you. As when you are coating this stuff, it, to me, it kind of like, you know, it sort of sets but doesn't fully cure, doesn't set, more like it stiffens to a point where it would be unfinishable, where if you tried to finish it, it would just start turning. So the places you get that the most, the hardest areas are the joints, and that's why if you're doing anything big, this isn't a one-man job, as you'll need one guy to keep on coating while one starts to finish. And that'll result, if you don't do that there, it could result in tears and sort of ripped areas when you try to drag the float, the plastic trowel that I was showing you assembling earlier. You could kind of, you know, you'll start to see tears and rips happening, and you'd actually be better just leaving the wall alone. It would actually look better just troweled on than it would with all these wee the puck marks in it, basically. The only time that's, that it almost happened to us on one job way long time ago, actually, when I was working for other people, the heat was unreal. It was a summer and the heat was unreal, and it, in one part, it just started to go like that, and we had to really, we had to step it up, we had to speed up, we had to finish it quicker. There was actually three of us working, and there was a labourer scooping to us, and again, it was all about the weather, but we had to just motor on. And I mean, like, if we had just been a wee bit slower and a wee bit more lazy, it would have been a disaster. The whole wall would have needed done, and it was a big wall. So, you know, you kind of do want to know what you're doing with this kind of gear, especially it's so expensive. But yeah, so my tips would be nice, clean tools, guys. Clean your hawk, clean your trowel. Rubber gloves are good, as this stuff will stick to your hairs. It's very hard to clean off. As you can see, my arm covered in it. It's very hard to wash off yourself. And again, weather, you're going to want nearly two dry days, completely dry days with no rain, because this stuff actually takes a wee while to fully go off. On this one, it actually did set, but the bottom sort of 6 inches still stayed soft the next day, and there was rain coming in, and I was very, very panicking. But you know, I came and checked on it again, and it was fully solid, so I was happy. Got away with it, but again, you would not want a big downpour of water hitting an acrylic wall that you just finished, no way. But basically, how it goes is, as you've seen, I primed it, actually a couple of days before, but you want to make sure your primer's completely gone, and then you'll just apply it with your clean tools, clean scooper, and mix up the gear before you start. Give it a good drill, and again, some people say add water to it, but if you actually read the book, it doesn't say anything about putting any water in it, guys. So, you know, if I was you, the price of this stuff, don't be trying to dilute it. Just put it on. It doesn't say on this bucket that you can dilute it, so don't do it. Again, putting it all on, and actually you put it on, and then you're actually trying to cut it off and cut it off and cut it off again. The stuff does stick very, very well, but the idea is you want to keep it on nice and thin, and that will allow you to be able to finish it more or less straight away. And again, like I said, the reason you want to do that is because it kind of does set a bit, whereas it won't be finishable. So you do want to finish it each lift as you go, very, very quickly. Again, you know, I don't want to keep saying it's all about speed, but a lot of it is speed, and it's a hard sort of thing to learn without doing. But if you're going to do it, you know, you would be better off doing it alongside somebody that's done it a good, you know, at least 10 jobs or something, that just sort of really know what they're doing, they know what the problems are. That's, you know, that's one thing that you get with experience as well. And some people think that experienced people charge a lot, but sometimes I do think experienced people also know what can go wrong. And on the likes of these jobs, you know, if something goes wrong, it can go wrong very, very quickly. And it doesn't take a lot, you know. Like, for instance, if somebody was to lift a plank above here, it could flick dirt all over that wall, which you're not going to get off. And if you try and touch it up with the trowel and it starts turn, it's game over for the wall, you know. So just be silly things. Even as that, again, weather. I do find it hard to rely on the weather. As you've seen with the primer, it wasn't supposed to rain that night, but we got a heavy shower, and it didn't all have to be primed again, but certain areas did, and a couple of the windows got a bit of a splashing, so they needed a scrub and stuff as well. But again, it could have been worse. Like I say, I've had no bad luck, I'd have no luck at all. But yeah, it could have been worse, but it could have been better. You see here, it's a bit awkward around this pipe and around the sills. And, you know, it seems like it's a simple thing to do, but it actually, you get a queer burn on the arms putting this stuff on. And you'll know you did a day's work after one wall. But yeah, so get it on and get it rubbed as quick as possible.
Next, scribe back plastering.